It just so happens that this little piece of technology has four unique stories to tell the can industry. The first story is about durability, and to tell this story, I'd like to take the valve apart and show you what's inside. The first thing you'll notice is the simplicity, and it takes an amazing amount of engineering to arrive at a patented design that is this simple. And in the simplicity of the design lies its effectiveness. The external body is a coil, and when energized, it moves three stainless steel balls very quickly, a tiny distance, to allow air to flow through the valve. And that's it for the valve design. It is that simple. The only wear parts are these stainless steel balls and these seats. And because of this, these valves are rated to last 5 billion cycles. And regardless of how you do your calculations, 5 billion cycles will result in a life of years, not months. The second story this valve has to tell is one of performance, and the performance is tied directly to its responsive design. In the Bodymaker, compressed air is used to blow off or strip the can off the punch. And because the can is gripping onto the punch, compressed air is sometimes not enough, and stripper fingers are used to help the compressed air remove the can from the punch. This graph here shows what a strip air profile looks like using the existing valve technology in every Bodymaker around the world today. For half of the Bodymaker stroke, the compressed air is off. And when the can needs to be stripped, the valve opens, the compressed air travels down the ram, and eventually fills the can, allowing it to be stripped from the punch before turning back off. I want to point out the spike at the beginning of the compressed air profile. This is a result of any valve holding back compressed air. Once that valve is opened, the head pressure will immediately add an additional force that helps strip the can off the punch. That impact is good for stripping a can. Now, here's a graph that shows the profile of the AirSAVE valve. The big difference you'll notice is that the AirSAVE valve is capable of cycling much faster, allowing it to cycle 2 to 3 times per every single Bodymaker stroke. The performance benefit of multiple pulses per every can is that the impact helps strip the can off the punch. Imagine how an air hammer or an impact wrench works. And I'd like to use this very same graph to share the third story this valve has to tell. This story is one of air savings, and this is why we call the valve AirSAVE. If we simply compare the profile of the existing valve with that of the AirSAVE valve, it's easy to see where the air savings comes from. Now I'd like to talk about the cupper and how its strip air system works. At lower speeds, the cupper works much like the Bodymaker, turning compressed air on when it needs to strip a cup and off again once it's complete. But at faster, normal operating speeds, cuppers stop cycling the strip air, turning the compressed air always on. Imagine the air savings opportunity here, always on versus cycling. For both the Bodymaker and the cupper, the compressed air savings can be worth a lot. But just as important as the air savings, the fact that this piece of technology minimizes the electricity used to manufacture each and every cup and can. And this is the fourth and final story that this technology has to tell. For the can industry to make good on the sustainability promises it is making the world, we need technologies like this. To put this into perspective, replacing one cupper with AirSAVE valves on an annual basis eliminates the electricity equivalent to this.